On the show today, Gaurang Shah to help you with the fundamentals and Ruchit Jain to help you with the technicals. Morning, gentlemen. Let's get the show started with the first query of the day. This is Bharat on the phone line from Ahmedabad. Go ahead, Bharat. What's your query? Bharat, can you hear me? All right, a bit of an issue with his phone line, but Ruchit, he has a query on Stovek Industries. His buy price is 2,500. He can hold for about a year or so. Any view on this chart?
Good morning, Vipashu. Well, if we see the daily charts and the volumes on a daily basis are very low, firstly, in this stock. And usually, whenever we see any stock with such low volumes of, I think, 15 to 20 shares on a daily basis, it's very difficult to do any kind of research or technical analysis on such illiquid counters. I can give any view because of this illiquidity, but I can just provide him the support levels. 2600 is a good support for the stock looking at the short to medium term charts. So since he is quite, since he's in the money in this stock from his buy price, I would just advise him to keep a stop loss above his cost price. So that would be a prudent strategy. It's difficult to do any kind of timing when the prices would again resume the broader degree uptrend or move higher because of low liquidity in this name.
All right, there you go, Bharat. You can keep those key levels in mind. Difficult to give you, you know, exact targets to look for. You're already making money, though, on an Stovek Industries. Let's get in our next caller then. This is Kuldeep calling us from Bharuch. Go ahead, sir. What's your query?
Hello.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah. Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Sir, we can hear you. Go ahead. Tell us your query.
Yeah, sir, actually, मैं भूषण स्टील और नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर के बारे में कुछ जानना चाहता था. एक्चुअली मैंने 10,000 भूषण स्टील का 35 रुपए के उससे परचेज किया है. व्हाट अबाउट द फ्यूचर्स और कितना मेरे को अगर अच्छा इसमें मार्जिन लेना है तो कितना लॉन्ग टर्म कितना टाइम मेरे को होल्ड रखना पड़ेगा इसको.
ओके, और कोई स्टॉक
सर? भूषण स्टील और नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर.
ओके रुचित, कमिंग बैक टू यू, भूषण स्टील एंड नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर. भूषण स्टील द बाय प्राइस इज 35, National Fertilizer, the buy price is 60, can hold for the long term. What does the chart structure tell you for both?
Certainly, if I come to Bhushan Steel first, then definitely the trend for Bhushan Steel is still negative. We have seen that this is one of the stock which has, within the metal space, has shown a big underperformance as in, and has in fact destroyed wealth even of traders as well as long-term investors. So my advice would be to look to exit from Bhushan Steel. I think within the metal space, if he wants to stay, then JSW Steel or even Tata Steel is quite a better option, which are trading at good levels. If the volatility is quite less in JSW and Tata Steel compared to what we usually see in Bhushan Steel. So exit from Bhushan Steel at current levels and shift to JSW Steel or Tata Steel from a long-term perspective. Second is NFL. Within the fertilizer space, I think although NFL has already seen a corrective move in last 6 months, but I think even here, I would give some other alternative compared to NFL. GNFC is one of the stocks which has shown outperformance within the fertilizer space in the recent past. And if you see the positional or the long-term charts, then definitely the long-term trend is also positive in GNFC. So my advice here would be to again to switch from NFL to GNFC from a long-term perspective. We could see about 25 to 30% returns in next 6 months perspective.
सर, एडवाइस तो यही रहेगी कि भूषण स्टील और नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर आप दोनों से एग्जिट करें. दोनों इस समय थोड़े प्रेशर में आ सकते हैं. भूषण स्टील एनीवे आपके कॉस्ट के आसपास है तो ज्यादा आपको लॉस नहीं होगा. नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर से भी मूव कर ले. भूषण के अलावा आप जेएसडब्ल्यू स्टील या टाटा स्टील में इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हैं और नेशनल फर्टिलाइजर की जगह आप जीएनएफसी गुजरात नर्मदा वैली फर्टिलाइजर में आप इन्वेस्ट कर सकते हैं. ये अगर आप करेंगे तो आपको अच्छे रिटर्न मिलेंगे. तो इन दोनों स्टॉक्स को एग्जिट करिए और इनके अलावा इन स्टॉक्स में आप निवेश करिए.
All right, hope we could answer your question, Mr. Kuldeep. Our next caller is Dheeraj calling us from Gurugram. Go ahead, sir. What's your query?
So, I have bought two shares.
All right.
One is Power Grid. Mm-hmm. And Power Grid, I have bought 1,000 shares at the rate of 190.
All right.
Which I understand is a very good and resistant rate for it because it doesn't go beyond below 189 and 190. But as I understand, the share has been moving within the bracket of 189, 90 to 213 or thereabouts, and does not break that cycle normally. And its EPS is very high. Its EPS is about 12 or 13, and by which if I discount it was 15 also, or 20 maybe. In my understanding, it should go high. So I wanted to understand what is its target and in what time can this target be, you know, be achieved. That is one query. And the second query is that I have bought Equitas holding at an average price of 157. And I am holding 5,000 shares for that. So I wanted to know what is the target and in what time period these can be achieved.
All right. Since you've asked for exact targets, Ruchit, I'll just get your view on both these stocks as well. Equitas, 157, so losing a bit on that, but Power Grid is around the cost price at the moment. Can hold both for the long term. What kind of targets would you be looking at and what kind of time horizon should he keep in mind as well?
So for Power Grid, you rightly said that the stock is more of a range-bound stock. Since last one and a half year, in fact, we have seen the stock has traded in the range of 185 to 215 to 220 on the higher side. And usually whenever such a range is going on, only thing you can expect if this range-bound move continues for another 6 months or 4 months, then prices could move higher from lower end to the higher end of the range. So my advice in Power Grid here would be to continue holding the stock. The target projection again would be the higher end of the range which we had seen in last 1.5 years, that is around 215 to 220, and the time frame would be about 4 months for the stock to test the higher end. 185 is a support, so I think that maybe a couple of percentage lower below 185 should be kept as a stop loss on the existing long positions. Equitas has seen a lot of volatility in the recent past, although 135, 132 is a good support range for the stock. And on the higher side, 160, 165 has been acting as a good, acting as a resistance in the recent past. Now, since the prices have already corrected since last 1 month, so there is a higher probability that the downside from here on would be limited. Around 135, I think the stock should take support and again show a pullback move up to 160 again, similarly in next 4 to 6 months perspective.
All right. So
that, Richard, the short-term view on Sterlite Technologies at 310 and Divi's Lab at 100.
So Sterlite Tech, the stock has now been forming a lot of low-term structure on the daily chart. Secondly, the key moving average support, which were acting as a support in the recent past, have now been breached. So I don't think the stock would give any significant up move from here on in near term. 285 to 288 would be the very strong resistance in case if you see any kind of pullback move. So as of now, I would advise you to hold with the stop loss below 265. But on any pullback move towards 285 to 288, look to exit from Sterlite Technologies. DB's Lab within the pharma space, definitely we have seen since last 1.5 months, pharma space has witnessed very good volumes. Most of the stocks which were in oversold zone, such as Sun Pharma, Dr. Reddy's Lupin has given, Glenmark Pharma has given a very sharp up move. Although DB's has not participated in this up move since last one month, but the broader trend for the stock still continues to remain positive. And prices are trading near their medium to long-term support. So I think the downside in DV's Lab seems to be quite limited from here on. So continue to hold DV's Lab with a stop loss below 1,000 rupees. And you can expect targets around 1,120 to 1,115 next 1 to 2 months perspective.
All right, so clear advice there from Ruchit. You need to exit Sterlite Technologies in and around current levels, so maybe on a little bit of a rally. Hold on to Divi's Labs. 1,000 should be the stop loss. 1,100 plus can be the target on that one.
Ruchit, on the charts, any good levels that he can watch out for, either to book out of a Piramal Enterprises or your view on a CESC?
Piramal Enterprises, if you see last few trading sessions and definitely on the move, the stock has witnessed good volumes. So I think in near term, maybe the stock should show some more pullback. We are already seeing the stock moving higher from 2300 to 2600. And this up move is likely to extend up to 2750, 2780 kind of levels. So I believe that he should hold for another couple of months in Piramal Enterprise if he wants to exit around 2750 to 2780. Those who I think should be good levels to exit from the stock. CESC is rather into a consolidation phase right now, and I'm not expecting any significant momentum on either side from a short-term perspective. So if he has a long-term view, then I think he can continue to hold because the long-term charts are still positive, but I'm not expecting any significant move in either direction in the near term.
All right, there you go, Firoz.
Ruchit, if he was looking at an exit price, anything that you can recommend? I know there won't be enough data for these charts, but what can you recommend?
Similarly, there is not enough data, and whatever data is available, in that we can clearly see a lot of low bottom structure. I can't figure out any one instance where the prices have shown on any kind of pullback move with good volumes post this demerger. So I think even at current levels, they should look to exit from the stock. What we have seen during the second half of 2017, the mid-cap stocks have shown a significant up move. So if the stocks are not participating when most of other mid-cap names are going up, then definitely you should consider exiting from such names and switch to some other stocks which could recover his losses. Even at current levels, I would recommend to exit from this stock.
Right, so both Gaurang and Ruchit recommend that you exit at whatever level you can rather than have your wealth erode further. As far as both of these names are concerned, they have recommended a lot of better alternative ideas that you can put your money in, recover your losses and maybe make some gains as well. Ramesh is the next caller from Chennai. Go ahead, Ramesh, what's your query?
Sir, good morning.
Morning.
I have two questions. One is BHL, about the BHL.
Okay.
I bought a BHL around 76 rupees.
Okay.
500 shares. Can I hold or sell?
Okay.
I have planned to hold for 6 months. What about the outlook? That is the first question. Second one, I bought a NBCC, National Building Construction Company. I have 200 shares I bought 2 months before. What is the outlook? That is my question.
Absolutely. Ruchit, coming back to you, 4 to 6 month outlook on BHEL. In fact, that stock is at 52-week lows right now. What can he expect? And NBCC, again, has been a little weak ever since the split happened. What can he expect?
Certainly, even BHEL is one of the stock which had shown an underperformance in last 1.5-2 years. And as of now, there are no signs of any trended up move in the stock. There may be pullback up moves, but rather he should look to exit from any kind of such pullback moves. 82 to 85 now is a very strong resistance for the stock, which may be revisited in the next couple of months time frame. But look to exit from that pullback move around 82 to figure. Rather, if he wants to make a switch, I would recommend switching to cement sector, which we have seen that Ambuja Cement, ACC, even these are a couple of names which prices have corrected in the last 3-4 months. And the stock now have been showing signs of reversal patterns on their weekly charts. So from 6 months perspective, I think it should make a switch over from BHEL to some cement names such as ACC or Ambuja. As far as NBCC is concerned, yes, the prices even here have shown a decent corrective move, but I think the stock is now trading quite close to its long-term support, which is the 200 weeks moving average. Usually the 200 moving average on the daily or the weekly charts acts as a very strong support when prices correct near those levels. So I think from here on the downside could be limited. He can look to average out NBCC at current levels of 80, keeping a stop loss below 74 or 73, and a pullback move up to 96 to 98 could be expected in near term.
All right, so pullback expected in an NBCC if you want average at these levels and then watch out for 90 plus. But for both NBCC as well as BHL, be mindful of the levels that Ruchit has mentioned, especially the support zone. So on that note, completely out of time on this edition. Of Call BTVi, Gaurang and Ruchit, thank you so much for your time. We are here every Monday to Friday at 11:30 a.m. Do keep sending all your stock market queries to us. We'll make sure they're answered by our panel of experts. Our details are flashing on your screens. Thank you for watching.